Alrighty. I'd like to welcome you all to the first day of the LHL here today, Sunday, May 22nd, kicking off our LHL Season 11. And we have three exciting matchups coming at you tonight. We have Vancouver at Toronto. We have Philadelphia at Chicago. And we have Colorado at California. All these are exciting, exciting matchups, and the teams just seem to be really well balanced out. The preseason going fairly well, each team picking up a win except for Philadelphia, who I believe played most of their games without Claude, their GM, and White are probably considered their best player. But as we're coming out with the two juggernauts from the preseason head-to-head at the beginning of the season, K-Bombs, Vancouver, and Toronto's NHL killers, Toronto, both powerhouses. K-Bomb, the lineup of Taser, KS Auto, Kapanen, and Legendary Trev. All of those guys, excellent players. And if he gets all of those guys to show up, then he's gonna have a fantastic lineup with himself and net. And on the Toronto side, the visitors, we have NHL killer and Austin on defense, Galchenyuk and DMB up front, and Meatsail, the ever-talented goaltender in net for Toronto, who is widely considered one of the best goaltenders in the game based on raw skill, but he doesn't practice quite as much as the rest of the goaltenders. And we have backups that we could potentially see on both teams. For Toronto, we got Marchi, Drag, and Zeus Orphan. Zooks, one of the better players from a couple years ago, coming back this season. Not able to make many RSL games because of work schedule, but he should be able to make LHL games. And not surprising to see him picked up, even if it is in the last round of the draft, because he is immensely talented. He brings good scoring. Drag and Marchi, but some leading scorers from the RSL last season. Both of them picked up first and second overall in the RSL draft this season. So excellent offensive talent on the backup side for Toronto. Marchi's actually been known to play a little bit of defense, but definitely not known, like, not what he primarily plays. We have X-Parabolex, excellent defenseman. If he didn't have so bad attendance issues, he probably picked up more for RSL. And I actually drafted him on my team, and hopefully he makes a big impact. In Kwoof and Slim, I haven't seen him play in years, seems like, and Kwoof is rock solid as a player as it gets. Has the capability to be a low-end LHL starter at any position, but he can fill in anywhere, and it's excellent to see that he's showing up for his team. So as we got a couple minutes, I believe 7 minutes now towards 6 minutes now until game time start. Gonna run you down some stats for some players last year season. DMB did not play last season, so didn't record anything, but it'll take me 1 second to get this pulled up. Waiting for this spreadsheet to load, so I apologize. And it's interesting to point out that all these games today are actually rematches of the first day of preseason, which I casted last Sunday. And all these teams have seen each other before. Toronto taking that win, I believe, last week. So it's interesting to see if Vancouver can come out with some revenge. I believe DMB just sort of turned up later in the game and made his team known. And of course, unfortunately, last season, the Toronto was bounced in the first round, but NHL killer coming up with 35 points, 15 goals, 20 assists, for 1.67 point per game, playing at D, which is very respectable. And he had Parabola playing on his team then, who got picked up in the other time. So he knows a little bit how he plays, was his defensive partner for a little bit. But Parabola picked up 5 goals and 2 assists for 7 points total. And other side, K-Bom, the all-star goaltender for, got picked up and for Florida, and they had a rough season. K-Bom posting up a 58.45 save percentage with, but he put up an incredible 128 saves to go along with his 22 games played, and probably kept the Panthers in the games they probably had no business being in, but unfortunately Florida was not very good. Matt not being able to make most of the games sort of broke their season, and Evkov got stuck with the short end of that stick. But if you go back another season, well, I cannot find where K-Bom played last season, because I'm bad at looking at spreadsheet teams. Ah, he played in Tampa Bay, where he didn't post up much better of a save percentage. 58.85 save percentage, 113 saves. But again, the team wasn't super fantastic. 9-0-4-12 for a 31-point team. Not great, not awful, but certainly not Florida, but he has put up better seasons than he has before. I believe in season 6 he was the best goaltender, period. And he can turn up at the right time to really give his team a better look at winning these games. Going back to season 8, he had a much better season. 64.49 save percentage and 16 games. Of course, seasons were a little bit shorter then. Well, as we're waiting for games to get started here, we only got a couple minutes left. I'm gonna get my client loaded up. See if I can find the server. So just a couple more minutes now, waiting for teams to hop in here. Austin looks like he's already hopped in the server. And just a little bit of a countdown here for the LHL Season 11, opening day. And first game of the season, the preseason juggernauts head-to-head. We got Toronto at Vancouver. Just in here, just one more minute. I'll try and give a little spiel about some of these other players. And Taser, universally regarded as one of the best defensemen in the league, is was interested in playing forward this season. But if you look back in the LHL seasons, you can, starting from I believe season 2, he's been an elite defenseman ever since then. He's the GM of the Chicago Blackhawks, 23 points. Of course, that's a season where Dial put up 104 points that season, 75 goals, but 4v4 format. So 23 points, you look at season 3. 26 points. I mean, he's an absolute monster and consistently has been since the beginning of this, the competitive aspect of this game. Putting up 91 points in season 4, so definitely an offensive powerhouse. He has to be regarded with some fear if you're going in there. Cannot let him get going, and if he gets some confidence early in the season, it could be messy for the rest of the people in the league. He's really quite elite, and not only that, but he's got Chaos Otto, who... Looking back at season 4, since I'm already here, he had 108 points out, the leading scorer of season 4. For the Toronto Maple Leafs, and go Leafs go, otherwise known as NHL killer. So he knows what they do. He knows what how it plays like, and these two leading scorers from season 4 reunited on this team, so... An elite pedigree on Vancouver, and but NHL Killa and DMB, an elite pedigree in a sort of a land of their own. And it looks like Toronto's taking the ice here. And looks like we kind of got a surprise lineup here. Starting lineup as but people who are on the ice right now, Quacky Face, draft in the third round of the RSL draft, Austin, NHL Killa, and Dragon DMB. So yeah, it looks like Quacky Face in goal for Toronto. I don't even know if he's on the roster for him. He wasn't when I checked earlier. Or he wasn't when I checked in the preseason, but... Guess early roster moves being made. And the first period, we are underway. It looks like we have a 4v5 going here. We have Chaos Otto, Taser, and Kapanen, and K-Bomb and net for Vancouver. See if that elite pedigree of Chaos Otto and Taser can actually pull out a win here. Yeah, I don't see him in the LHL roster sheet at all. So I guess that him not being able to make games has affected his stock of GMs. And if you can't show up to make games, then you're not going to be able to play games. So looks like we got both teams on the ice here. And the first period, we are underway. It looks like we have a 4v5 going here. We have Chaos Otto, Taser, and Kapanen, and K-Bomb and net for Vancouver. See if that elite pedigree of Chaos Otto and Taser can actually pull out a win here. And of course, it's Vancouver in red here, and Toronto in blue, in case my stream's overlay is wrong. Which it doesn't look like it is. That's a breakout pass from Kapanen up to Chaos Otto. He gets it, and that's Quacky Face way out of the net to play that. It looks like attendance comes. Oh, a shot from Kapanen, just finding wide of the net. Sent deep. That was by Drag up to DMB. DMB across to Drag. Second overall draft pick of the RSL draft, trying to make an impact here in the LHL. Austin chips it into the corner. KS Auto over to receive. Of course, Taser has a little bit of experience playing in 4v4, and so does KS Auto. Both season 4 statistics I listed off were played in 4v4. But obviously, if you're playing a man down, it's a little bit challenging, and your goaltender's going to need to be able to handle the puck very well. K-Bomb's out of the net to do that right now. Makes a breakout pass up to DMB, who mishandles it. Looks like that was up to Kapanen, my bad. And DMB intercepting that puck. DMB makes it around one and makes it around two. It's just 3-on-1. DMB chips it over. NHL killer gets a tip. That's going to be a save by K-Bomb. Kapanen across to KS Auto. Counterattack for for Vancouver. KS Auto puts that on goal, but Quacky Face denies that shot. Taser puts this shot. That's going to be off the post. Quacky Face steers it wide of the net. Taser has it back on his point. And this is K-Bomb. Has own goal. Shoots it straight up the ice. Oh, NHL killer got that, but he was interfered with by Austin, his own teammate. Quacky Face clears it down the ice. Kapanen, this is a bad turnover. Kapanen just dumps it deep. Wasn't able to get a handle on it and had too much pressure. Looks like Drag's taking over the net as Quacky Face comes out of the net to play that. That's NHL killer. Turned over. And here comes NHL killer. In on the left wing. Drops it off. Austin on the point. Shot wide of the net. This is DMB. In the far corner. Plays it up to Drag. On the point. Plays it across. Tried to get a cross crease pass there, but nobody was home. KS Auto recovers for red. Gets it stripped away from him by NHL killer. NHL killer centers. Shot. Score. DMB scores the first goal of the LHL season. 1-0 Toronto. Face-off won by NHL killer playing forward here. Drag sitting on the defense. Drag pinches in and dumps it deep. KS Auto in his own zone. Taking that reverse from Kapanen. He gets squeezed off the puck by NHL killer. Austin throws it deep after catching an errant pass. Centered and off the post. NHL killer is going to bury his second for his team right there. NHL killer from DMB. 2 points apiece. And it's 2-0 Toronto. And the one man advantage here. Oh, Slim shows up for Vancouver just in time. Well, for the end of the first period. And Slim is a fringe LHL player and has been most seasons, but he has the capability for greatness. Has taken over the game quite a few times. A little bit of luck and a little bit of skill combined. But now that numbers have evened out for both teams, we're looking at a little bit more even contest. Vancouver's got a long way to climb against that stingy Toronto team. Whoa, sent across. That was DMB. Slim, not warmed up. Cannot get that puck across. And wow, that was DMB backskating, trying to possess that puck. It's cut in the corner, and K-Bomb dumps it away. This is Quacky Face for Toronto. Dumps that deep. DMB. Whoa, shot. That was a spin shot backhander. Oh, it gets deep. Cannot score. Is in alone in the slot as time wound down. But could not turn that on goal. Couldn't even test K-Bomb. As we're looking at shots here, we got 3 for Toronto, 0 for Vancouver. But that's not exactly surprising as Vancouver was playing a man down for most of the period. But we'll see if they can make a comeback in the last two, or can Toronto continue their dominating as they started the game. DMB off the faceoff, turns it over to Kapanen. Kapanen had three guys all around him, and he couldn't make anything happen. Taser, JSL pass, right to the other team. Austin to Drag, who cannot receive that pass. It's a little hot to handle. Drag's just going to dump it deep for DMB. DMB behind the net. Got a little deep. Austin pinched on that play, and that's going to be sent back in Quacky Face. He's going to let that go. NHL killer. Played around, but Slim has it now. Pinching. This is Kapanen. Backhand opportunity. Just wide of the net. NHL killer on his own near boards. Gives it to DMB, who just dumps it deep. K-Bomb out to play it. Plays it across. A little bit dangerous. Kapanen's going to be received this, though. And a minute left to go in the second. LHL season opener right here. Slim shoots, tipped, not able to put that on goal as he tipped it away from the net. Oh, sent out to the front for Taser by Otto, but not able to connect. Gonna have to look for a little bit more chemistry there. DMB sends it deep. Looks like they're looking to just send these pucks deep and make it play a simple game. Make Vancouver come to them. And this is Drag. Excellent on the forecheck. Puts the shot high of the net. It looked like that one got tipped. NHL killer centers it across. Not able to find Drag. DMB cannot find the back of the net. I believe that rang off the post. That was a sharp angle shot. And Austin playing excellent defense for Toronto. NHL killer in on the forecheck against Kapanen. Gets it out of midair. DMB in the corner. Centers to NHL killer, not able to find that one. That was a great saucer pass, though. And Drag, pinching in from the defense, centers it. And here we go. KS Otto in 1v1. Gets around Austin, but he has to slow down. And that's four members of Toronto collapsing on that lone Vancouver attacker. And that physics puck away. And here comes Kapanen on his backhand. Not able to center. This is Slim on the left point. Pressured by DMB, and that's going to be stripped away. Toronto's been relentless on the forecheck, always pressuring these Vancouver players who have not necessarily experienced handling the puck. Kapanen's not probably used to receiving this much offensive pressure. Now we saw Dial was the main draw of offense for or defensive coverage, and then what a great center. That was DMB to Drag. And it's 3-0 Toronto. NHL killer in on a breakaway. Puts it on goal, but K-Bomb with a great save to try and keep his team in this. That's centered. Out in the slot. Rolls out to the point. In DMB. DMB hounded by forecheck by KS Otto, but Drag, good supporting forward, and K-Bomb out to play it for Vancouver. Taser chips it off the boards back to himself, and he's got momentum. He's going to look to carry this. He draws the fence. Dick DMB played that away. Excellent tip play, and oh boy, Quacky Face in alone. Biggest test of the night. Put on goal. Tipped away. I believe that was off the post. I don't think that ever saw the net. I think Kapanen rang that one right off the post, and then it just fluttered across the crease. No one able to put that one in. Just a little tap was all they needed. DMB deking out Kapanen, deking out KS Otto, but Kapanen buries that one. KS Otto put enough pressure on for DMB to turn that one over, and Kapanen puts the Vancouver within two. A one face-off by Toronto. That has been the story of this game so far. One face-offs and one possessions. 30 seconds left in the second period. Let's see if Vancouver can change the narrative. Oh, but Toronto needed a big save from K-Bomb, and they got it. This is Austin at his own blue line. Plays it across to KS Otto, but wrong team. Oh, floated. I thought that might have been a tip play that NHL killer was going for. And that's going to be dumped right down the ice. 10 seconds left on the clock. I bet you Drag fires this up for one shot. And it looks like he's just going to dump it. And that should be the period. Unless NHL kill the centers. Ooh, ran out of time on that one. 3-1 Toronto. After two periods of play. We're waiting for this next period to start. There's the faceoff. This time it's actually won by Vancouver. This is the first faceoff they've won all night. That's sent on goal. Quacky Face steers that away with a backhander. And that's flipped into the zone by blue team. That'd be Toronto. Oh, bad rebound off the boards, and DMB is not going to miss from there. Defensive coverage had to be there, and it just wasn't. And that's going to be 4-1 Toronto. A one faceoff that time by Toronto. And it has been all Toronto. I've said Toronto quite a bit this game. And NHL killer puts that on goal. K-bomb with the save. This is KS Otto in behind his own net. Austin pinching in. Puts that near the net, off the side of the net. And that's played around by DMB. Slim for Vancouver. Plays it across. Kapanen not able to receive that puck. I think they need to switch up the assignments here. Kapanen needs to sort of play a little bit more defensively. And KS Otto, who's known for his finishing power, had 108 points in season 4. Probably one of the higher career point players in this entire game. Needs to play more offensive role. And this is played back into the Toronto zone. And NHL kill is going to not get there first. This is played across to Kapanen. Is he going to get this on goal? Cannot. Looking for a spinning shot. And DB is going to try and carry this out of the zone. Hopefully it goes a little bit better than it did last time. DMB shoots. Tipped. Oh, Taser almost tipped that down. And, well, he did tip it down, but it almost tipped it on goal. This is dumped away by Taser. He needs to make crisper passes. Dumps are not going to cut it here with three goals to surmount in 3 minutes. We're in the third period here. Toronto's up 4-1. Shot. Deflected away. DMB showing he can do it on both ends of the ice. Taser steps up. He's in on the forecheck now. Slim. Trying to pressure NHL killer here, but that's going to be Otto taking, or Kapanen taking away center. Quacky Face steers it away. Slim. Puts it near the net. DMB blocks that one. And this is going to be sent wide of the net just barely by DMB on a dump. Would mitigate icing in NHL, but LHL, we do not have icing. We don't have offsides. And Slim carrying it back in his own zone, reverses to Taser. KS Otto. KS Otto has a little bit of space, trying to go back out in front. KS Otto gets it stripped away by drag. Taser, whoa, right across the crease, but nobody's able to put that on goal. And K-Bomb is out to play this one as he had four players pinching in here. K-Bomb flubs it. DMB puts it near the net, but he never had control of that puck. Drag. Turns it over to Taser. It's 1-on-2. Taser, Austin, and KS Otto. KS Otto looking to make some havoc. But Taser is just going to roof that one. Taser from Slim makes it within two with 1:30 left. Vancouver pushing four guys into the Toronto zone. Every time they get the puck. Quacky Face flubs it. Oh, no. Put away. And that's a goal. Taser puts it within one. Quacky Face flubbed that one and gave up a huge rebound. And that's going to be 3-1, you know. Quacky Face has not known for playing goaltender. I believe he played a little bit in Season 4, and I believe he plays it as an off position, but he usually plays offense. Oh, boy, Kapanen has a wrap attempt. Oh, he just puts it wide of the net. This is shot. What a save by Austin. He just steered that one away from the net. K-Bomb about to play it. 50 seconds left. Put Eyed on the stick of Taser. Taser shoots! Goal! Kapanen scores! They've tied up the game with 45 seconds left. And here we go, face off. The comeback is complete, but we still have 40 seconds left of hockey here to play. Taser looking for another goal. He's in. He shoots off the post. Oh, what a shot, and what a little bit of luck from Toronto. They've let this three-goal game collapse on him. That gets dumped down in the zone. Slim recovering for Vancouver. Plays it around the net. They are trying to get to overtime here. There is no loser point here. Oh, no, bad turnover. DMB just gets it deep. K-Bomb out to play it. Risky reverses around the net. Austin's going to have an opportunity to shoot here. 8 seconds left in the game. Puts it on goal. What a save by, that was Slim blocking that out of midair. And that's going to go to overtime. What a great way to kick off this LHL season. And Quacky puts it in his own goal after the intermission goes. So we have some overtime hockey here. Extra hockey as we're going right into this. It's a continuous overtime golden goal here. So whoever scores next wins. And here we go. Off the faceoff drag. Pressured. Not a natural defenseman. Usually plays offense. And DMB in on the forecheck against Slim. This is a player mismatch right here. DMB not able to get it away, though. It looks like Chaos Auto comes back to help out. And, oh, Chaos Auto gets around DMB. Auto to Taser. This is the chemistry you're looking for. Taser on his backhand. Puts it near the net. Not on goal, though. This is Kapanen on the forecheck. Puts it around Austin. This is behind the net. Quacky face out of the net. It's always risky to see those goaltenders playing the puck. Taser stepping up. He's going to have an open shot. Shoots. What a save by Austin. What a block. I mean, Austin might want to consider playing goal. He centered out in front. That was Kapanen looking for a goal. A lucky bounce or anything. Whoa. Put it in front. Kapanen wins it with a hat trick in overtime. Vancouver wins it. 5-4 after being down 1-4. And what a way to kick off this LHL season. But we have more games coming right back at you. Wow, but what a way to kick this game off, this season off. I need a little bit of water, and I'm going to check the Twitch chat out here. And Toronto, as Waldo points out, Toronto getting upset as they were the leader coming out of the post or the preseason. I tell you what, and when they played them, Toronto and Vancouver actually played in the preseason. They did not look good. So K-Bomb and Vancouver actually finding some chemistry to make some in that week of preseason. That makes this game look a little bit more even if. Vancouver was getting a little bit outplayed in the first two periods. They ran it back with 4 goals in the last game there. As we're waiting for the next game to get underway, we have Chicago at Philadelphia. Taking a little preview of those rosters. We have Claude Giroux, Big V, Tall Midget, Meow Force, otherwise known as Ticklebox, and Capital Skis, starting in goal for Philadelphia. Claude, excellent offensive player. Tickle, kind of moved up from the RSL. He was an excellent RSL player, and see if he can make the jump back to LHL. You know, he was a GM for the Anaheim Ducks and back in Season 4, which, you know, I know all the stuff about Season 4 because that's just when I was played the most. But we'll see if he can make the jump back into the LHL. Tall Midget and Claude Giroux on offense, and they are the huge dynamic duo. If Tall Midget and Claude can actually find some chemistry, they are going to be an offensive force to be reckoned with. But I'm not sure there is an offensive pairing more scary than Dial and Guy LaFleur. Guy LaDial, I've turned him. But they are truly terrifying when they... if they can find some chemistry. I would be not be surprised to see both of those guys at the top of the leaderboards for scoring in one moment here. I'm actually switching these textures about. And of course, they have excellent backups. Pet the Pizza, known for playing offense, known for playing a little bit of defense, but not quite as much. Trevco, making the jump up. He's improved a lot over the last few seasons, and it looks like we're getting game underway here, so let me cut you right back to it. Philadelphia at Chicago. Chicago is in blue, so I got that one right, but I did not have time to change jerseys, so Chicago, you're just going to have to imagine the red and orange from both teams. That's one. That's down and deep. And Trevco going to have Chicago's first shot of the game. That was a little trickler, but it counts. It would have gone in the net. This is... Looks like GT's in net for Chicago. Briz not able to make this game. Pet the Pizza and Trevco on defense. And... But GT had an excellent RSL campaign last season. Cannot exactly remember what team he played for, but he played excellently. Came up with a plus 60 save percentage, which is always good. And he was looking to make a bid for the LHL this season. Whoa! Guy LaFleur from Pet the Pizza almost put this game, put his team up one. And Pet the Pizza sends it up to Dial. This is Big V. Puts it across, but GT not even tested there. This is Guy LaFleur. Sends it across. Guy to Dial. Not able to make that one go, and that was Capital Skis making a good save. Can't let that roll across the goal mouth. Big V plays it across. Tall Midget. Tall Midget bounces off the board. Centers. No one's home. 3 minutes left in his first period. Lots of long play from both teams. So Dial receives that puck. Germ steps up to take that one away. Germ's not the starting defense for this team either. Usually it's it would be Ticklebox in his base, but I'm not sure if Germ's Ticklebox not able to make it, or Germ's just impressing Claude so much that he actually made the starting position. Oh, and here's a turnover. Claude's going to get here first. Misses the puck. Oh, that's got to be a little rusty right there, and Dial's going to try and make him pay. Gets around one. Big V, big defensive play, and that's going to keep this game tied. As Dial was not going to miss if he gets past Big V. And had him drawn off, could probably have taken the shot if he went outside that time. But you can best way to score is a breakaway. And I don't blame him for going for the higher scoring opportunity. GT is going to be tested there. Long shot by Claude Giroux. Looks like this is Tall Midget playing it back to Big V. Claude looking to collapse. Not able to get there. That was a blue defender clearing it away. Guy LaFleur. Plays it up the side for Toronto. This is Dial. He's going to get there. He's lethal from anywhere, and that's off the side of the net. Tall Midget playing it across the middle. Oh, Germ's not able to receive that puck. He's backskating. Can't get to it. Oh, he swipes it away. And oh boy, Tall Midget makes a mistake of a play there. And Dial plays it up to Pet. Pet not able to make a threatening chance off that. And this is Tall Midget, otherwise known as X-Tall Midget. Used to be part of the XYZ chem, but remove the X for some reason. And Tall Midget puts that on goal, but GT stands tall. And the, of course, the XYZ chem being Zook Orphan, two Ys and X Tall Midget. And a long shot from Guy LaFleur, I believe. That was going to be a huge save by Capital Skis. And it's a melee behind the Philadelphia net. Tall Midget. Plays across. GT Safe, but it's on the goal line. Who's going to clear it away? And that's going to be cleared away by the Chicago player. It's played in behind the Philadelphia net. And dumped down on the ice. GT's going to have to steer this one away. This is Dial. Across to Guy. Cannot receive that puck. He's going to have a chance to center here. Plays it back to the point. Trevco still has it. Gets it deep. And that's going to do it for the first period. Looks like Claw just jumped in and out trying to maybe solve ping issues. You know, his computer's not the best. Face off here to start the period. Won by Chicago. Whoa, dangerous play by Pet the Pizza across the goal mouth. Plays it up to Trevco there, who does receive it. Guy of floor. Backhands it across. Dial. Oh. Not able to receive that puck. He plays it around. Guile 4 is going to have to play this. But Gurms gets there first. Reverses. Claude Drew has time and space. One man to beat. Gets wall deked. But Pet the Pizza makes a smart play and takes the body. Ooh, Pet the Pizza. In? Not in alone. Centers! Ooh, cannot find. I believe that was Guy LaFleur out in front. And Dial's actually on back here on defense. Going to look for maybe a long shot. Sends it across. Shot on goal. Oh, steered away. That was Guy looking for that wacky spin shot. Claude trying to streak in on a breakaway. He still has it. Oh, great back checking by Chicago. Dial out of the air. What a monster. Dial nearly won the LHL finals for his team, carrying them back from... carrying him through Taylor's Washington team, almost single-handedly in the game that they did win to bring that game an overtime game 7 win. And Dial absolutely has the ability to take over games and whoa, Guy with the spin shot. Capital Ski is steering that away. Shot, ooh, wide of the net. They're looking for these tip plays that are a little too cute. I think they just need to start putting stuff on goal. Centered, oh, they're looking for, still looking for those tip plays. Chicago style of hockey. Whoa, put on goals. Guy LaFleur scores his first goal of the season. Guy from Dial. And that's Dial the guy right there. 1-0 Chicago. Midway through the second. Plays it across, and this is Trevco. He just walks it right in. Everybody whiffs on it. He's going to have an opportunity. But, oh, great back-checking by Claude Giroux, making sure his teammates stay a little bit alive. And Claude shoots. Ooh. Steered away by GT. GT's been tested pretty well this game. He has faced 4 shots and so far has stopped them all. But in alone, wow. Wide open net, and he just missed it. I at least make the goalie make a save there. You can't just miss there. But I guess I can't talk. I have no offensive talent whatsoever. And this is Big V in his own zone. Dumps it across to Dr. Gurms, his defensive partner. Gurms on his backhand. Whoa, looking for Claude there. Claude was almost in a perfect position to tip that, but that was Trevco, I believe, slotting that one out of the air. This is Capital Skis elevating it out of the zone. This is Trevco, though, for Chicago. Gets it stripped away by Tall Midget. Tall Midget has the chance for redemption here after missing that open net. Oh, here we go. Claude scores that one. That got blocked at the defense, but whichever defender wrecked himself was needed to check himself because that was not a good play. Fell on his butt trying to spin and not gave up a bad turnover off the block and can't ask for too much easier goals if you're Claude. Oh, centered. Guy not able to hit that one out of the air. That was a finesse play I've ever seen one. that was dumped in deep by Philadelphia. If there was icing, that would be it. But as there is not, play will continue. And that sent across. Guy whiffs on that shot, but it's going to find its way on goal. He was trying to increase the speed of that one a little bit, because at that speed, you're not going to beat Capital Skis. This is Claude turning it over to Pet. And a good pinch there by Dr. Germs. This is a very wide open hockey. Chicago's making these really long stretch passes that are forcing Philadelphia to play really far back. Like we have Pet across the dial. Chips it, but Big V pinches. Puts it deep, and Pet is in a good defensive position. And that was sent almost all the way back. Big V hitting that one out of the air. Centered. Shot. Save made by GT. What a save. Claude Giroux had a wide open net. Only one man to beat, and that was the goaltender, and he couldn't do it. GT makes another save at the end of the period there.
Buddy joined your channel.
Hello, user. Hi, Lucic. Joined by Lucic here. Former LHL great. Or LHL great, not former. Did not sign up this season, though. And here we go. We got a face-off one by Philadelphia here. Sends it deep. Trev Crowe taking it up on the far boards. Oh, here comes Dial. In the neutral zone, has space. He's just going to put this on goal. He sends it across. Why would you pass that? Everyone thinks that he would, everybody would think that was on goal, but it was not. Tried to send that across the Dial, but that's a futile effort. That's sent on goal. Wow, and what a shot. What a goal. Germs with a perfect Bantam shot to put his team up one. Goals from Germs and Claude Giroux. Minute into this third period here.
Ooh. Can come back. Nice pass by Dial.
This is Big V to Pet the Pizza. Pet the Pizza. On a backhand. Narrow angle, not able to pass it across. Shot. Nobody's able to get a tip there. It looks like Guy is just kind of planted out front, but looks like that there's always Philadelphia sticks, or the pass is just too hot to get across to Guy. This is Dial. Plays it up to Boris, and Germs going to pinch in on this one. And Germs gets it deep for Claude. Back skating. Is that Matt? No, it's not. This is Trev Crowe for Chicago. Plays it up the near boards. Guy gets wrecked there by Germs, and Capital Skis out on that to play it. Oh, that's turned over. Dial not able to get a stick on it, though. Pet the Pizza. Pet the Pizza up to Dial. He's looking to receive this pass. He is looking to shoot that one off the one-timer. Reverses it. Pet the Pizza is going to get there first. He's going to have a shot opportunity. Shoots, tipped away. And that was a nifty play from, I believe, Talmadge just to get it up the ice. Using a stick angle, or changing his stick angle while passing it up the ice. Trev Crowe in behind his own net. Chicago's looking for some offense here. Had a 1-0 lead, and now they're in a 2-1 deficit. Halfway through the third period, that's a shot on goal. Capital Skis
risky.
Gave up a big rebound, but great body by Germs, I believe. But another shot, tipped away by Philadelphia stick. Played up the ice, and Trev Crowe's not able to keep it in for Chicago. GT plays it across. Excellent pass to Guy LaFleur. Leaves it for Pet the Pizza. Pet the Pizza's not going to get there first, though. And a good pinching Trev Crowe. And here comes Big V. Oh, 3-on-1. Tall Midget comes back collapsing. Tried to set up a little drop pass there. And that's a shot. Tipped.
Scored! What a goal.
Trev Crowe and at the tip at the defense. not aiding his goaltender there. Minute 45 left to go in the third period. Shot by Dial. Off the post. Off the other post. And cleared away. Capital Ski is getting a lot of help from his posts there. And I believe that that did not go in the net. What do you think, Lucic?
No, that was not it. So, it was a good shot off the face-off, you know.
But
good at making that work.
But a little Capital Ski is definitely getting some luck.
Oh,
and not that time. Dial with an excellent opportunity to score his first of the season. Chicago looking at that one-goal lead. Philadelphia looking to tie here. The momentum shifting very quickly and goal. As some of those lucky plays that Chicago was looking for still haven't worked out. They're finding scoring other ways. And the game is busted wide open in the last 45 seconds for Chicago. Three goals. Two from Dial. One from...
I think Philly was trying to set on the lead there. You got to continue with the play.
And a shot. Dial with the goal. No, I wouldn't... All right, so the last minute here has been all Chicago. And Philadelphia has played a very good game with... all things considered, but they've lapsed here in the last minute. And I think that Chicago, all they have to do is coach this one out. This is going to be played up to Pet the Pizza. Played away from Guy. And that's centered out in front. Capital Skis. There was nobody home for Philadelphia playing defense. Pet the Pizza. Put this one just wide of the net. On the near side, Claude Giroux shoots it straight up the ice. This is Tall Midget looking to center to Germs. He's not going to get there. He didn't get there. Steve, Tall Midget could not center to Big V, and that's going to be game over. 5-2 Chicago as they busted that game wide open right at the end of the game. And next up, we have Colorado at California. Colorado, I don't believe Jabba is starting, but it's possible. But Jabba's got the team of Dildozer, Dick Bug, Bo Horvat, and Doucette. And he's got three goalies on his team, Sully, Nina, and the Ace. Whereas Cabinetry has a much solid, a much more confident team where he's got Dolphin, Gabe, BGP, Nargila. Nargila, I believe, being the starting goaltender for for California. As we're looking to get this next game underway, Colorado at California. Taking a look at the backups here for California, they have I'm Not Stamkos, DeBeezy, and Omaha, a much well-rounded...
Buddy joined your
buddy
channel.
Left your channel. Buddy hey, left your channel.
Not sure what happened there. But we have better well-rounded set of backups as opposed to three goaltenders. But Jabba can play at any position himself. And as long as he has the best goaltender for the job, then I guess there's no problem. And that was Lucic leaving the cast, so... Sayonara to him. Thank you for joining us. Hope you come back sometime. Oh. We're waiting to get this game underway. It looks like we're waiting on some... Or it looks like we're waiting from players from both teams. Shout out to all 9 viewers watching the stream right now. You guys are all awesome. We're waiting for this last game of the LHL season to get started. Or not last game of the LHL season. Last game of the first day. And it looks like California is taking the ice here. We got Crab in a Tree, BGP, Dalfan, Gabe, and I'm Not Stamkos. I heard some rumors of Gabe playing net. And I didn't quite want to believe they were true. But I guess that seems to be the case here. And here we go. We got we have McJeebly Jubilee 69, otherwise known as McJabba, Sully and Net, Bo Horvat and Ace on defense, and Doucette rounding out the Colorado lineup. Let me switch the cast back over to this. You can actually see the game, and we can get this one underway. Can I get some captors in the chat? Please. Because I'm going to rerunning a Gabe breakaway counter. And as we get this game underway, that's I'm Not Stamkos putting that wide of the net for California. And that's played up the ice to Ace. Good defensive play. Oh, and Dalfan pinches in. He's got an opportunity on his backhand, puts it wide of the net. This is Bo Horvat, otherwise known as Johnny Hockey, getting forechecked by I'm Not Stamkos. Stamkos out in front, out of the air, not able to put that on goal. I'm not sure where it is, but oh, there it is. Ace coming out of the corner with it. That's behind the net, BGP for California. BGP played in Boston, or for games for Boston last season. He was excellent. Also the leading scorer in the RSL last season. Played it forward, of course, but now he plays defense in the LHL. This is floating around. Set on goal and scored! Crab in a tree from Dalfan. This is Ace for Colorado. As California finds himself in an early lead. That's sent deep by Colorado. BGP blocks that shot as it was actually going to end up on goal. Sent deep for Crabbin and Tree. Tripped away from him. Sent deep. BGP again recovering. Dolphin not getting a whole lot of defensive work. BGP taking up the big load there. I'm Not Stamkos. In on the forecheck against Yaki, the recent unretiree. We have Crab in a Tree. Tried to do a little too much and gets it stripped away. And behind the net. Played up to Doucette. Doucette sends it across. Jabba not able to receive that. Hot tamale of a pass. And this is Doucette in on BGP. Dalfan carries it out of his own zone. Deeks out Doucette. And McJubilee Jubilees. Jubilee Jubilees. 69. And grab a tree out in front. Not able to put that one home as that one went right off the post. And this is I'm Not Stamkos for California. Dalfan, actually, he deferred to Dalfan, and this is going to be I'm Not Stamkos again. Shoots this wide of the net, if just by a hair. And Jabba's going to put that up to Doucette, who lays it up for Ace, but not able to put that on goal as that was intercepted by a California player. Whoa. Excellent move. Keeping it on a stick. That's put on goal, but an excellent block. I believe that was by Dalfan. Dalfan. Hitting it out of the air back to himself. And this is going to be McJabba. Gets round one. Puts it up. Not able to put it on goal. This is excellent block by the defense, I believe, by Dalfan. Cross corner dump by Bo Horvat. BGP reverses. Dalfan. Had a little swipe by Jabba. Fends it off. And Dalfan. He can carry the puck out of his own zone. As good as anyone. He puts it on goal. Tip by Red. Off the goal. Oh, that was a save by the Red player right there. And Sully lucked out a little bit on that one. In on the forecheck.
Hey, wake up.
Right, I apologize. I had a little bit of familial difficulties there. There we go. Had to step away from the computer, so I apologize. Looks like it's 2-0 for California. This is Bo Horvat back in the corner. Plays it up to Doucette. Now is McJava trying to put that on goal. Grabbing a tree. Has it in. Slight break. And a physics shot that, luckily for Sully, went wide of the net. It's still bouncing around. And we never know when this settles down. And that was about 15 seconds of physics right there, so I apologize. And that's sent back towards the goal. Gabe plays that away. He probably could have just settled that down, though. And it looks like Vancouver's yet to register a shot, and it looks like that's the first one. It looks like I just commentators cursed it. And California putting up excellent pressure with 8 shots on goal. So, all California through 2. But still with definitely within reach for... Oh, I have the wrong... I have the wrong team set up here, my bad. This is actually Colorado. So Colorado without shots in the first period and put on a win late in the second. Gabe Gretzky counter regrettably sits at 2-0. And this is Colorado. Bo Horvat pressured by Crabb. I'm not Stamkos. Came up from the JSL. Played well in the RSL when he was played last season. Now he made the jump up to the LHL this season. Oh, a whiff by Dalphin. Don't see too many of those. He pursues the puck. That's up to I'm not Stamkos. This is Crabbe in a tree. Shot just over the net. Doucette. In behind his own net. And it's played across. Crabbe in a tree has a partial break yet again. Just to get around one man. He does. Here we go. Shot saved made by Sully. Sully standing tall here for his team when they need him most. And that's Jabba wrecking BGP out in the open. And this is Dolphin in behind his own net. Pressured. Gives it up to Ace. He's going to have a shot. Puts it wide. Bo Horvat. Sends that one. Wide. Plays it up to I'm not Stamkos. Had a partial break. Not able to get around the last man. And good defensive hockey game so far for California as their defensive strategy just seems to be having the puck the whole time. 10 shots on goal so far for California. So sends this across. I'm not Stamkos. Not able to put that one on goal. And this is sent up to Jabba for Colorado. And California still with the puck. Colorado has not had a good possession so far since I've sat back down. This is Dalphin played up to Crabbe in a tree and Crabbe in a tree. And on a breakaway, backhand, save made by Sully. Standing tall like he did in the RSL last season, had a 70 save percentage in that league. Did not stand super tall for Boston, but maybe the little extra practice has come out to help him. And here we go. Shot. And blue team sort of just standing around waiting for something to happen after that shot. They're not moving. And not ready to make that happen. Ace. Other shot attempt. Wide of the net. Bo Horvat. Shot! Whoa! Good save by Gabe. Has not been tested all most of the game right there. But that time he was. Even if the shot counter didn't record it. This is Jabba. getting bodied off the puck, and it's back to California possession. An excellent clean game so far. Minute 30 to keep it mistake free. Dalphin shoots it across to Cabanatry on the far boards. Bo Horvat stepping up. Bo plays it up to Doucette. Doucette not able to put that or pick that one up. Cabanatry whips that around, not able to find Stamkos. Just played up to Dalphin. Steered away by Gabe. And 45 seconds left. Jabba. Tried to get it deep, but not able to do so. Silly. Leaves that one behind his net. 30 seconds left. And it looks like this is not going to be that close of a game after all. 25 seconds left in Dalphin. And California have dominated the play so far. 11 shots on goal. Dalphin looking for another. And not able to find it yet. Ten seconds left. BGP with the puck, looking to just stall this game out. 5 seconds left. Cabanatry in alone, and that's 1 second left. That is game over. Colorado 0, California 2. And with that, I would like to bid you all adieu. It's been great casting for you guys, and thank you, everyone, for watching. Anybody who is still watching, this is a game called Hockey Question Mark. It's available for free. It's a first-person hockey game, and we sort of organize ourselves into organized leagues and try and have some fun with it. But I'm going to bid you all goodbye tonight, and I'll see you later.